In this video, we will bring budget lines and indifference curves together. After this video, you should be able to explain how a consumer maximizes utility within a given budget constraint. Now we will combine what we've learned in the previous two videos about budget lines and indifference curves. First, we will plot the budget line and then introduce three separate indifference curves. Assuming a budget of $25 with juice boxes costing $5 each and a piece of cheese costing $2.50 each. With that budget constraint, you can buy 5 boxes of juice or 10 pieces of cheese. As we bring in our three indifference curves, we should recall that IC1 represents a lower level of utility than IC2, which represents a lower level of utility than indifference curve 3. To find the combination that would maximize utility within a given budget constraint, we look for a point along the budget line that is tangential to the furthest possible indifference curve. In this case, the budget line is tangential to IC2 at point B. While the budget line also intersects IC1 at points A and C, the consumer would prefer combination B because it provides the highest level of utility given the budget constraint. Next, we will look at changes in price and income and the impact they have on the combination of goods that consumers purchase. First, let's take a look at how the combination of choices changes when there is a change in price. Similar to the video before, we increase the price of cheese to $5 a piece, which reduces the maximum amount of cheese we can buy to 5 pieces. This causes the budget line to pivot inwards. This will impact our previous diagram and change the utility maximizing combination. Let's bring back the indifference curves to see what happens. If we look at the original budget line before the change in price, we can see that point B is the preferred combination. However, after the price of cheese increases, our budget line shifts inwards and the new point of preference is D. It represents a lower amount of total goods due to the rise in price of cheese. Now suppose there is a change in income. Similar to before, we reduce income from $25 to $10, and this results in shifting the budget line inwards. If we bring back the indifference curves from before, we should be able to find a new optimal point. The initial utility maximizing point would be point V because it is part of the budget line that touches or is tangential to the farthest possible indifference curve, IC3. After income reduces, the budget line shifts inwards. We again look for the point that is tangential to the farthest possible indifference curve, which is now point Y. After watching this video, you should have a better understanding of how budget lines and indifference curves can be analyzed together to find an optimal consumption bundle for a consumer given a fixed budget and constant prices. If you have any questions or comments, leave them below or email me at enhancedtuition@gmail.com. You can visit me online at www.enhancedtuition.co.uk and check out some additional resources posted there. That wraps up this video and this topic, so I will see you all in the next one.